Greetings. I got a great question from someone in Islam. Just want your perspective on something in John 1, 19 through 25. John the Baptist was asked three questions to which he replied no to all three. My question to you is, who is that prophet that the priests and Levites spoke about? I'm not saying Mohammed, peace be upon him. Based upon your logical reasoning, who is it? And here is my answer. I hope you find it educational. Thank you, brother, for that great question. I'll answer it here in a few messages, but this deserves a video to thoroughly answer it. So thanks for a good video topic. In verse 19, the Jewish leaders ask, "Who art thou?" or "Who are you?" In verse 20, John said, "I am not the Christ." Hopefully you have no problem understanding that, right? John, or Yahya, was not the Christ, the Messiah. So that is the first thing to understand from verse 20, that John is not the Messiah, the Son of God. Point 2. Then they ask several questions in verse 21. Are you Elias? And this question means, are you Elias the prophet, or are you Elias reincarnated and alive a second time? And this is a source of confusion, because the angel said John came in the spirit and power of Elias in Luke 1:17. This means an anointing or an authority, but John was not Elias reborn or reincarnated. And John rightly answered, "I am not," because John was not the person of Elias. Number 3. Then the Jewish leaders ask, "Are you that prophet?" And we know this to mean the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. We know this because there are no other specific prophets foretold and unaccounted for in the Torah. And again in verse 21, John answered, "No," meaning John is not the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. Point 4. Then the Jewish leaders continued, "Who are you?" So that they could at least give an answer to those that sent him. So see, having said no to the first three, their question is, well, if you're not these three guys, who are you then? And John has a very clear and amazing answer about himself. He actually quotes a prophecy by prophet Isaiah from Isaiah 40, verse 3. "The voice of him that crieth in the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord, make straight in the desert a highway for our God." I encourage you to watch my video about this topic, because Yahya directly implies Jesus is God with his claim. Remember, these were my answers in a message to someone in Islam asking about John and the three questions. The true answer depends on understanding that the persons being asked about are not unique individuals. It is easy, but incorrect, to assume because there are three questions, there must be three separate people as answers. Because there is no scripture which says, "That prophet is not the Messiah." So the correct answer is that Jesus is both the Messiah, which those in Islam have no trouble accepting, and he is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. The logic is that one must read and understand the description of the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. He would be Jewish. He would be sent to the Jewish people. Point 6. Being sent to the Jewish people is a critical point to remember, brother. If we are to honor the God of Moses who sent the message, we must honor all that God detailed. And Jesus clearly said he was sent to the lost sheep of the house of Israel, Matthew 15:24. This absolutely fulfills and confirms one critical element of the prophecy of Deuteronomy 18. And we know that Mohammed never was sent to Israel as a prophet. Never, never, not ever. The only claim of him ever visiting Israel was an imagined night journey that no one saw or knew of or was aware of. And Muhammad never talked to anyone. Point 7. If you have not watched the video I mentioned, I encourage you to do so, brother. Because Prophet Yahya states that he, the prophet who baptized and prepared the way for Jesus, Yahya said that he, John, was the fulfillment of Prophet Isaiah's revelation of a voice in the wilderness, preparing the way for Yahweh, the God of Israel. This is a clear and irrefutable sign, my friend, that Jesus is more than a mere man, a mere prophet. And this is two prophets, Isaiah and Yahya, revealing this. And that basically sums up what I believe is the scriptural answer to the three questions for Yahya. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who Prophet Yahya revealed is Yahweh. Amen.